This is the Ludlow Court Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, brought to you in part by the Blue Willow Inn, gracious hospitality and superb southern food, and by Jasper Jeep. No matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. The toll-free line's now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. Or in Greater Atlanta, 770-205-2741. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. Miserable day. You're not going to like this at all. Stay in bed. Just a miserable day. Drippy rain. Hope it's better at your house. That's the way it is in the greater Atlanta area. And we are talking about hate songs. You know, we talked about love songs over and over again, get favorite love songs, because there have been a lot of those. Not as many hate songs, but just as much fun. Hate is probably not as much fun as love, but it's just as common and just an honest emotion. So we'd like to hear for what songs you fell out of love to. Songs about people who just hate each other. Been very close, and nothing dies quite as dead as a love. We've all heard that. Nothing. So we'll talk about that. Some of these songs, like Pistol Packin' Mama, If Your Phone Don't Ring, You Know It's Me, You're Wanted by the Police, and My Wife Thinks You're Dead, Homecoming Queen's Got a Gun, all of those, 1-800-572-8255. Going to be fun. Jump in here and join us. We'll even come up with some Hall of Fame ones. How about that? Matter of fact, I think we have come up with some Hall of Fame ones. Jump in here and join us. Easy to do no matter where you are, 1-800-572-8255, Somerset, Kentucky. My buddy, Bob, on the line. Hello, Robert.
Hello, Ludlow.
How you doing, buddy?
Oh, I'm doing fine. It's miserable here. You might call it, some family member said, sneak, between snow and sleet. Coined a new word.
Yeah.
Hate songs. Nobody's mentioned Oni, have they? The Johnny Cash song, Hey Oni?
No.
You remember that one, don't you?
I can't remember that one.
Oni's his boss, and everybody's had a boss like Oni.
Yeah.
And one of these days, old Oni, hey, Oni, you're going to get it. And he's just counting off, it seems like he's counting off the days.
Okay.
He retires or something like
that. Very familiar, but I can't remember anything else about it.
It's been a long time. I'd say it's the song's at least 25, 27 years old.
Yeah.
Somewhere along in there.
Boy, they just live on, don't they?
They sure do. Other songs, almost all the old ballads, you might say, in a sense, are hate songs, like Pretty Polly and Little Maggie.
Yeah.
Those are qualify. And one that you might not think, I think is, in a sense, it's a more complex song, is Working Man Blues. If you listen to it, you know the last line?
Yeah.
First he starts out blustering and blowing about what a heck of a man he is.
Yeah.
And finally it's cry a little of these working man blues.
Yeah.
Last line.
That's a very interesting approach that I never realized that. That's fun.
Yeah, it's an ironic song. And two songs that are Merle Travis songs, Merle Travis being a good Kentucky boy, I have to mention him.
Mm-hmm.
Dark as a Dungeon might be considered a hate song. It's a kind of a love-hate song.
Okay.
And so is 16 Tons.
Yeah, I guess, yeah. And that's a picture of frustration.
Sure is.
Another day older and deeper
in debt.
Yeah.
An old my soul to the company store.
Yeah.
By the way, on this, talking about Merle Travis, that finger-picking style, there's a father and son combination over around Princeton, Kentucky. Their name is Pennington. I can't remember their given names.
Mm-hmm.
That are masters of this style. And they're an up-and-coming act, so watch for them.
All right. What's the name again?
Pennington. I can't
remember.
Father and son, I can't remember. I've seen them on TV, and I've seen them live, too. So they're quite an act.
Sound like. We'll watch for them.
Okay, have a good one.
Hi, buddy. You do the same. Good to talk to you.
Bye-bye.
Just want to tell you about the Blue Willow Inn, gang. Listen, restaurant, gift shop, the whole thing. It is right there at Social Circle, Georgia, and you're going to love this place. Best chicken in the world, best vegetables, roast beef, ham. Everything that you grew up southern, you grew up loving. Now, having what they call a Fun Seeker special down there, so you need to take advantage of this. 25% off the regular price, and it's good now through April 14th. To receive your discount, reservations must be made in advance, and the discount must be requested. The customer is to tell at the time of making reservations that they want the Fun Seeker special discount. And when they dine, they receive a 25% discount. Best food around, best folks I know, best place to eat. Blue Willow Inn, Social Circle, Georgia. Tell them Ludlow sent you.
New from Crutco Records comes another exciting radio offer, an Italian love song serenade, the best of Volare. The best of Volare includes every recorded version of Volare from the 20th century, and it's now available on 13 CDs or 27 cassettes, and can only be obtained through this exclusive radio offer. You'll hear Volare, performed by some of the greatest singers in the history of song. Dean Martin. Also includes Andrea Bocelli, James Brown, George Jones, David Soul, John Gotti, Janis Joplin, Gene Autry, Tina Turner, and many more. The best of Volare. You've never had a compilation like this. So get your credit card ready and order now by calling 1-800-CRUDCO. That's 1-800-CRUDCO for the best of Volare.
And that dog track waitress messing with her friend. They're both checked in at the Wild Hotel. Honey gets a deer apple and a box of shells. She hangs out the car door, daughter holds the wheel. She gets the safety off and the scope to sit still. Pumps all the points through the don't leave skirt sign and left to wake up all for room 69. Her attorney's gonna have to get on his horse and convince the judge this was no more than a drive-by divorce. Drive-by, drive-by, drive-by
divorce. 1-800-572-8255. Ludlow and Denny. Wonderful day. Let's talk to Mr. Haney. Hadn't heard from Mr. Haney in a while. Mr. Haney, how you doing?
Oh, Ludlow, turning the wheels of commerce my direction.
You know, I was watching an old Gene Autry television show the other day, and I heard a man that got a voice very similar to yours.
You're kidding.
And I thought, I wonder how you can get away with impersonating Mr. Haney.
Huh. Well, you know, I think I know the fella you're talking about, but you know, I really don't see the resemblance there, but if you do, that's all right.
Well, not a physical resemblance. You're a much more handsome man than
you. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
That's all right.
Thank you. You know, you was talking about that Blue Willow Inn. You know, I gained 10 pounds just listening to a Blue Willow spot.
It's tough.
Yeah. Listen, I can't believe you've been on a solid hour and 15 minutes and have not mentioned a Charlie Pride song. It says it's a train load of ugly. Have you ever heard that one?
No, I heard the one about him sleeping under the picnic table to stay away from that witch.
Yeah, it goes something like this. You're a train load of ugly waiting to happen. They put the fire out on your face with a track shoes. Yeah.
And that's Charlie Pride, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. You know, he sang another one. I believe it was him that sang it. It was, Your Skin Don't Fit Your Face Anymore.
No, I hadn't heard that one.
But I don't remember the tune.
Jim Small's famous recording from down in Madison, In Enough Whiskey in Texas to Wash the Ugly Out of You.
Son of a gun.
That's
son
a big,
of a gun.
Big hit.
That Your Skin Don't Fit Your Face Anymore says, you're only as handsome as a Russian boar. Because your nose got slammed on the barroom floor.
Uh-huh.
Don't come to me. I don't love you anymore.
You like the classics, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do indeed. You know, that Jim Reeves song, Railroad, Steamboat, River, and Canal,
yeah.
That was followed up by, now this is on a serious note, it was followed up by a suck-up song. A falling star, that's what you are?
Uh-huh.
You must have strayed from the... You know, he must have felt pretty bad about about that hate song.
He did, or he was singing to his sister.
Must have been. Yeah. Well, I tell you, you know what? I almost came by there to see you a few minutes ago, but I decided I needed to turn the wheels of commerce just a little bit faster. But I do want to get by there and have a little coffee with you soon.
We're here all the time. Come on.
Well, listen. I'll talk to you later.
All right, buddy. I look forward to it.
Bye.
Take care, Miss Taney. Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. Knows a lot of those hate songs. Wrote a bunch of them. Cleveland, Tennessee. Helen. Hello, Helen.
Hello to you.
How you doing?
Fine.
Good.
And if I say Nancy Sinatra, I bet you know what I'm going to tell you.
These boots are made for walking.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my favorite. I liked that one. I don't know why, but I did.
Well, that has such a good beat to it.
Yeah, it did.
And it was one of the few things that she ever had that sold any records.
Yeah. Yeah, she didn't sell too many.
No, or need to.
It's just a little bit different as far as those hate songs are concerned. It was just a little bit different, and like you said, the beat was so good.
Yeah, I liked it.
Yeah.
All right, dear.
Okay, thank you.
Take care. Good talk to you, Helen.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255 as we go to Dexter, Georgia, and talk to Ted at the Streakaline Restaurant, Casino, and Golf Resort. Did I get it all in, Ted?
You got it.
All right.
You got every bit of it.
Good.
Yeah. I tell you what, that old Haney sometimes can be a hard act to follow.
Tough.
You know?
Yeah, tough. Man knows his country western stuff.
You know, he called me last night and told me that he had just gotten cyberized.
Is that right?
Yeah. He's gone high-tech, gone computer now.
Has he now?
Yeah. He don't know squat about him.
Well, but you don't have to know. You know, I mean, some real idiots know how to use those things.
Well, they try to.
I mean, but they don't use it successfully. You and your crowd, you know.
We're a crowd, too, ain't
we? I'm more of a mob. A crowd has a leader.
That's right. You look up anarchy in the newest edition of the dictionary now.
There they are.
there we is. I got a few hate songs for you.
All right, good.
Top of my list, two songs, is Little Drummer Boy and My Favorite Things, Whiskers on Kittens.
Uh-huh. You hate those songs, don't
you? I hate them.
Why did I see that coming, Ted?
There you go. I just kind of floated it out there for
you. Yeah, I knew you'd like it.
But, no, there's another hate song by a group called Limp Bizkit. You familiar with them?
No.
Yeah, it was the theme to the Mission Impossible movie. It's called Now I Know Why I Hate You,
uh-huh.
Why You Hate Me.
Uh-huh.
And the first line in there is, Now I Know Why You Hate Me, because hate is all the world has seen lately.
Ooh.
Yeah, kind of cuts right to the point.
Yeah, it does.
And then, of course, there's that old Allman Brothers song there, Gimme Three Steps. You know that one?
No.
About he was cutting a rug down at a place called The Jug with a girl named Linda Lou.
Yeah.
And in walked a man with a gun in his hand looking for you-know-who.
Oh, yeah, I know. Leonard Skinner.
I mean, Leonard Skinner. Yeah. I said all the buzz. What am I talking about? Threw
me off.
I am sorry. Oh, God, where am I coming from? Oh, man, I just need to hang up and go back to work.
I hate for you to go, but no. I understand you're a busy man running that empire down there.
Yeah, and that El Paso song by Marty Robbins,
mm-hmm.
He was in there, down there, dancing around with that Cantina, Farina, whatever they called her.
Farina. I don't know.
You know, there's El Paso. I wonder if there's an El Falo.
A what?
An El Falo.
Don't know.
If you got an El Paso, you ought to have an El Falo.
I understood it.
it
was not funny the second time either, so there.
Well, oh, no. As many times as I've called you, I ought to learn when to leave well enough alone.
Well, come on by here and see us. The coffee pot's on.
All right. Well, there.
All right, take
y'all
care.
Go see us.
I'll do it, buddy. Bye-bye. 1-800-572. He thought if he explained it again, it'd get funny. We'll be right back after I tell you. Listen. Oh, did he? I've been 24 years of business at the Woodbridge Inn. Let me tell you what they're doing. to show their appreciation for your patronage, they're going to roll back the prices on some menu items. Listen to this. $10.95, and here's what you get for $10.95. You get your Caesar salad or soup du jour, then your choice of roast sirloin of beef with mushroom sauce, boneless breast of chicken parmesan, pan-fried filet of flounder, lemon cream pie or hot fudge cake. It's available through January and February, 7 nights a week. Reservations are requested, and they really want to thank you for all your loyalty over the years and the wonderful food that you have taken out of there or eaten right there. It's wonderful. Just absolutely gourmet dining at the Woodbridge Inn, Jasper, Georgia. You tell them Ludlow sent you.
My friend Paris says Larry likes me, Dad.
Mm-hmm.
He's a boy on the baseball team with big brown eyes and way cool hair. He just makes me want to scream.
Uh-huh.
Daddy, my friend Paris says Larry likes me, Dad. He's on the baseball team with big brown eyes and way cool hair and a smile that makes me wanna scream.
If our kids' words were set to music, maybe we'd all be better listeners. This is Wynonna reminding you to tune in to your kids.
Ooh, he really makes me wanna scream.
Is that right?
A message from the Country Music Association and the Advertising Council. Visit us online at tuneintokids.com.
Well, I heard that you're leaving. Gonna leave me far behind.
So far behind.
Cause you found a brand new lover. You decided that I'm not your kind. So I pulled your name out of my Rolodex. And I tore all your pictures in two. And I burned down the malt shop where we used to go, just because it reminds me of you.
That's right.
You ain't gonna see me crying.
Now there's your hate song. 1-800-572-8255. Mike in Allendale, South Carolina. Good morning, Mike.
Good morning, Mr. Ludlow.
How you doing, old friend?
I'm doing fine.
Good.
Do you remember the one about the great big old farmer who went down to the honky-tonk to beg his wife to come back, Lucille?
Picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah, he hated her.
What a passion.
And with it, and had every right to.
Oh, yeah.
Sitting at that table with Kenny Rogers.
Mm-hmm. Knew he'd never get her back.
That's right. Didn't much care.
And I got a little one I wrote. I don't know if it's a hate song.
Well, let's see.
It's kind of short.
All right, let's do it.
Nobody loves me. Everybody hates me. Going to the garden, eat some worms.
Oh, yeah.
Long, lean, lanky ones and short, fat, squishy ones. Golly, how they tickle when they squirm.
Go to eat some worms.
Uh-oh.
Mike, you have a great day. Is it raining up in your neck of the woods?
It's misty, drizzly.
Yeah. Well, it just hadn't stopped here since early this morning. You
it's
take
been care. Doing it all night.
Take care of yourself, buddy.
You do the same now.
Talk to you soon.
Okay,
bye-bye. Let's talk to Mr. Completely. Hello, Mr.
Hey, man.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm still asleep.
Good. Good for you.
You know, the weather outside is sleep weather.
Mm, it really is.
Austin Lounge Lizards have one.
Mm-hmm.
And I know Denny has it, and maybe he'll play it sometime today. It's called You're the Monkey on My Back.
No, I remember it. Also, what a talented group that is.
Oh, they're wonderful.
Really,
I have several of their discs, and if I get a little down, I go get one and put it in.
Great.
They
work hard. Great novelty songs.
Not all hate songs have to be sad.
Oh no.
You know
that Tony Bennett thing. Want to be around to pick up the pieces?
Yeah.
A lot of folks listen to that for years and don't realize it's a hate song.
Well, I was one of them.
Yeah. Easy.
But anyway, that's the only one I could think of. Everybody else is doing a pretty good job, but I love You're the Monkey on My Back.
All right, you hang in there. We'll talk to you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. I know the last listeners, but I don't know that song. Maybe someday. Ludlow and Denny on the Fun Seekers Radio Network. We'd like to have you jump in here and join us. Having a good time in the rain. Now, it's going to be a good day tomorrow because Dr. Cooper's going to be here. So you be here with us, and we'll teach you how to keep your waist from getting really, really large. And you know what you do once you come off your diet. It's an awful thing to behold. All right, now, gang, what we're going to do is check in with O'Neill outside, brought to us by our friends at Georgia Power Company.
With the cold days of January ahead, it's a difficult time to offer a fishing or hunting trip to the uninitiated. Sometimes, this time of year, we have to recruit partners. Staying warm is the key. How so? Well, if you want to expose someone new to the outdoors experience, the biggest mistake would be to freeze them on their first outing. Here are a few little things you can pass on that will help make a cold day tolerable. Keep your feet warm with waterproof insulated boots. Don't skimp in preparation here. Buy the best you can afford. Use a good hat. Over 10% of your body heat escapes through your head, some more than others, if you know what I mean. To keep your body heat in, use a turtleneck pullover or heavy scarf. You'll be surprised at how that one thing will help. Gloves, too. Good ones. Use hand warmers when it's really frigid. Let's see. Warm head, feet, and hands. You're all set. Now this from Georgia Power. You know, there's nothing like sharing the great outdoors with someone who appreciates nature. Hi, this is your old fishing buddy O'Neill, and I've spent countless hours exploring the state with lots of decent folks. And they all feel fortunate to have so many places to fish and swim and camp. But what most people find amazing is that the reason we have access to places as beautiful as, say, Tallulah Gorge and Lake Juliet is because of the people at Georgia Power. Now, they set aside 33,000 acres to create 9 wildlife management areas and even encourage their employees to go into schools and teach the kids about the outdoors. In fact, the State Department of Natural Resources gave Georgia Power the Forestry for Wildlife Partnership designation. And that's something we can all be proud of. Isn't that right, sir? I thought so. A message from Georgia Power, the Southern Company.
Well, I guess it was back in 63 when eating my cooking got the better of me, so I asked this little girl I was going with to be my wife. Well, she said she would, so I said I do. But I'd have said I wouldn't if I'd have just knew how saying I do was going to screw up all of my life. Well, the first few years weren't all that bad. I'll never forget the good times we had, because I'm reminded every month when I send her the child support. Well, it wasn't too long till the lust all died, and I'll admit I wasn't too surprised the day I come home and found my suitcase sitting out on the porch. Well, I tried to get in. She changed the lock. Then I found this note taped on the mailbox that said, "Goodbye, Chucky. My attorney will be in touch." So I decided right then and there I was going to do what's right, give her fair share. But, brother, I didn't know her share was going to be that much. She got the gold mine. I got the share.
All right. She got the hate song. And I'm so sorry. I married you, so. 1-800-572-8255. Canton, Georgia. Buddy on the air. Hello, buddy. How you doing, my friend?
I'm doing fire to Midland.
Good.
Yeah. I've got one that come to mind. I really don't know who sung it. You might know this one. Knoxville Girl.
A lot of folks did that.
They did?
Yeah. A lot of folks recorded that. Knoxville Girl.
Met a little girl in Knoxville.
Yeah, beat her to death.
Yeah. That's a true story, right?
Yeah, it's probably a true story. Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I understand.
Yeah. All right, bud. You take care.
Do you know one about, I got one that I can't think, you might get something on this. I believe Stonewall Jackson, down in Columbus, Georgia, or Waycross, Georgia, way down in Columbus, Georgia.
Yeah, it's called the Columbus Stockade Blues.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Okay.
All right, bud. All right. Good to talk to you, buddy.
Yes, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. Cornelia, Georgia, and Laura right here. Hello, Laura.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, you rascal?
Pretty good. You?
Good, good, good.
I'm sure the song I'm going to tell you about you hadn't heard of.
Okay.
It's by a group called Ugly Kid Joe.
Ugly Kid Joe.
And it's called I Hate Everything About You.
Boy, that kind of covers it.
It talks about hating her mama, her daddy, her sister, her hair,
her dog,
everything.
Her goat Leon, all of it, yeah. Where could one find a record like that, you say?
At any record store, I believe.
Okay, well, that's kind of perfect sense when you explain it.
There's a couple of more. I have a book that I've been looking at. Billboard's book of top 40 country hits.
Oh, really?
And there's some hate songs in here.
Oh, I bet there is.
Bonnie Millsap.
I bet there is, yeah.
Has one called I Hate You.
Uh-huh.
I Hate the Way I Love It by Johnny Rodriguez and Charlie McLean. Aaron Young, I Hate Myself.
Yeah.
And I Hate Goodbyes, Bobby Bear.
Oh, we all hate goodbyes. Don't you hate goodbyes? They're awful, awful.
I think one popular one is the Dixie Chicks, Goodbye Earl.
Goodbye Earl.
They kill him off. They
kill
him
off
Earl.
Well, did he need killing? That's what we must ask ourselves. Apparently he did. A little group of young ladies wouldn't kill him without voting on him, wouldn't he?
I don't know. So they decided those black eyed peas would just do him in.
All right. All right. You hang in there, my sweet.
You have a good day.
I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Denny says he has it on first-hand authority that a march is planned by guys named Earl to protest the song. It's going to be called the Million Earl March. And the Million Earl March is in May. 1-800-572-8255 as we talk to the more than wonderful guy with his hand up. Hello, guy.
Hey, Lud.
How you doing, bud?
Somehow I missed you yesterday.
Where'd you go?
Well, I was right there at the Waffle House.
Everybody there remembered you, but they didn't know where you were.
Oh, man, I bet I was in the restroom again.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I appreciate you coming down, though, but I was getting ready to fuss at you, but I guess if you was there.
Yeah, of course. Well, where are you now?
I'm in Ocala, Florida.
You hadn't moved an inch, have you?
Well, no, I'm closer, right down from Don Garlick's Museum.
That's where you were yesterday.
Yeah. How did I... Boy, I wish I'd seen you. Now, I'd like to be home.
Well, Denny, can you run to Florida and get him? Denny says he'll come down.
Okay. What time... I'll try to be out there this time.
Denny said just wait.
Okay.
Let me suggest something to you.
All right.
Get in the parking lot out there and build you a fire.
Okay, like some old tires or something. Smoke gun?
Anything. Just anything you can find, set it on fire and sit down beside it, and then we'll be able to follow the smoke.
Okay.
Yeah.
I hadn't thought about that.
Yeah, that's good.
I wrote a song while I've been sitting here.
You wrote a song?
Just last Friday.
All right.
If I ever get back to Georgia, you'll live to regret leaving me in Ocala and not accepting my collect calls, darling.
Bossa Nova.
Cha, cha, cha.
All right. Well, your troubles are almost over, Denny, getting ready to go.
You got time for one more?
Sure.
Opal.
It is a good one, isn't it?
That's a hate song, isn't it?
Absolutely a hate song. No question about it.
That's one of the classics.
Yeah, but maybe the granddaddy.
And You Never Call Me By My Name?
Another good one.
And I think the fellow's talking about Knoxville Girl.
Yeah.
Barry Manilow wrote that.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Sure am.
Yeah. I saw the words to that. Have you ever seen the words to it?
Yeah, I used to sing it in my show.
Oh,
years ago.
Did you?
Yeah.
It's awful.
That's a mean song, really.
Well, it is a mean song.
It's just, it's the kind of circumstance. So, sometimes stuff like that happens. And man's got to do what he's got to do.
Oh, really?
No, I didn't say that. You wait till I get home.
I'm going to pretend not to know you when you get here. You take care of your bad self.
All right, Merry Christmas.
All right, Diddy's on the way.
All right, I really appreciate it. Now I'll try to get out there and see.
Okay, do it.
But haven't blown the horn or something.
All right. Thank you. He's going to build a little fire in the parking lot out there in the Waffle House next to that drag racing museum. And the chance of him seeing you or the chance of you going pretty small. He's going to Morristown, Tennessee. Nope, can't do that. It is time for me to tell you about some places that you need to know about. I'm talking about the Georgia Agrorama. Listen, this place down there is just the way that things used to be. So if you take your children, you take your grandchildren, what you're going to be doing is taking them back in time. I have four areas, four distinct areas, a farm community of the 1870s, a progressive farmstead of the 1890s, industrial site complex, and a rural town. All in all, over 35 structures have been relocated to the 95-acre site and faithfully restored or preserved as they appeared at the turn of the century. Here's what you need to do. Get yourself on I-75, exit 20. Get off there, and you are there. Tifton, Georgia. Closed on Sunday, so go down there during the week or on a Saturday. Got year-round, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday through Saturday. School visits are possible, Group 2 special events. They'll do all of that. You might want to call them before you go. 912-386-3344. It's a step back into our history, gang, and a wonderful step.
No one wants to listen to my tale of woe. My friends are laughing, point and say I told you so. Say that you're so human, I should let you be, but I can't, cause you really got a hold on me. It's a weighted problem, I can't seem to solve. How in creation did the situation evolve? Ever since the day you told me we were through, there's a monkey on my back and it looks like you. I can't eat, I can't sleep, I'm in something.
Monkey on my back and it looks like you. Morristown, Tennessee, my buddy. James. Hello, James.
Hello there, Mr. Ledlow. How are you, sir?
I'm doing good, old man. You all right?
I can't complain for a poor old plumber.
Good.
I guarantee you. I'm originally from Athens, Georgia, down there.
I thought all plumbers were rich.
Well, you know, I tell people as long as the airplane payment's made, I'm happy.
Okay.
I'm from a little town down there called Macon, Georgia.
Oh, beautiful town.
And I used to sing back in clubs back in 1978, 79, 80, and on up through like 88, 89.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to pick with a guy that had a song called I Hate Hate, and his name was Razzy Bailey. And I just got in my car a while ago and understand y'all were looking for hate songs.
Yeah, yeah.
And I Hate Hate became a number one hit record for Razzy in 1979.
That's wonderful.
I didn't know if anybody had named that song or not.
No, we hadn't, but we sure are glad to get it.
Well, that's a good song, I guarantee you. Razzy's a good friend of mine. He lives in Brentwood, close to Nashville.
Uh-huh.
And I saw him last year, went through there and stopped and saw Razzy.
Well, that's good.
And so I just thought I'd holler the song to you. I Hate Hate, buddy.
James, we love it. You call us again, my man.
I appreciate you, my friend.
All right, buddy. Take care.
Thank you now.
Bye-bye.
Yes, sir. Bye-bye.
I Hate Hate. I like that. That's really a good hate song. And plus, I hate anybody that don't hate hate. So that can go on forever. Let's go to Spartanburg, South Carolina, and talk to Jim. Hello, Jim.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, looks like we're going to have some liquid sunshine here today.
Yeah, you going to do my rain or stuff?
Oh, yeah, that, yeah,
yeah.
The Weather Channel says snow by Saturday.
Yeah.
I think they need to change that or something. The grocery stores are getting stocked up too much, and they won't say.
Yeah.
Well, the lady called in and stole that. Said, you know, it ought to be the epitome of hate songs there, Earl.
Yeah.
That poor boy, they had it in for him, boy, whatever he done.
But he killed him, so he must have deserved it.
Yeah, well, then there's two or three more good ones there, you know. Dang you, they ought to take a rope and hang you.
That's a great one. That's a great, great,
and
funny
then,
Roger Miller song.
Oh, yeah. And then another one there, I really hate you because your feet's too big.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Ernest Tubb wrote that ballad back in the 40s there about the man that killed his wife and buried her in the basement. Walking the floor
over you.
He really hated that child.
I guarantee you.
Oh, Lord. Well, we ain't got too many more days to spring, so we can just sit back.
Yeah, but boy, anybody that tells you that they miss having snow should have been around here this year, shouldn't they?
Oh, yes. Yeah, I don't miss it. You can turn on your TV and you can turn and watch the weather in Chicago.
Yeah.
Where it's supposed to snow at.
Oh, you just put a little White Christmas on with Bing Crosby there.
Oh, yeah. I don't miss that. For many, many years, I had to trudge out in it, snow or no snow, whatever. But, yeah. You know, after you retire, you enjoy life more, Benny.
Are you easily retired? A lot of folks are not.
Yeah, I can sit and look out the window and see these people, when it snows, you know, shoveling their driveways to get out, going to work, and sitting there with another cup of coffee, thanking the good Lord I don't have to get out any.
All right. Well, then
enjoy life and Mayfield ice cream.
You're a man in love with retirement, and that's the way it ought to be.
That's the way it is.
That's the way it ought to be.
People tell me, don't you get bored? I said, I don't have time.
Plus, most everybody I know gets busier after they retire.
Oh, yeah. Well, you do all them things you didn't have time to do because you were working.
Yeah,
see?
Yeah.
Work gets in the way of a lot of things.
Actually. It does.
It does. It don't bother Denny, though.
No.
I don't think that.
All right, brother.
All right.
You take
y'all
care.
Have a good one.
You do the same. I'll talk to you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. It's hard to know how you're going to handle retirement until you try it. I know a lot of folks that just didn't work out for. I had an uncle who was a banker, and his son, he'd been retired about a year, and his son called me and said, Mama wants to know, would you come take Daddy out to lunch? And I said, yeah, is everything all right? He said, yeah, everything's all right, except Daddy's cutting the grass so often that he's killing it. So I went and took him out. Incidentally, he wound up going back to work. A banker all his life and went back to work as a banker. Our number 1-800-572-8255. It's the Blue Willow Inn Gang. Gracious hospitality and superb southern cooking right there in Social Circle, Georgia. Our number 1-800-572-8255. We're talking about hate songs. At the top of the hour, we're going to broaden that out, as we say. Add something to it. We'll have a good time. 1-800-572-8255, Ludlow and Denny. It's a great day to be alive. Let us go forth now to Fayetteville, Georgia, and talk to Chuck on the radio. What do you say, Chuck?
Hey, how about it, Ludlow?
How you doing, buddy?
Oh, pretty good. I just think about the good old days. You know, I was in the Air Force, and I came home on leave, you know, and this old gal, I thought I was rid of her, but I didn't want to. We wind up getting married.
Uh-huh.
And I had to go to New York to go overseas, you know. And when I got on that Greyhound, I just think about, thank God and Greyhound, I'm gone. I think they wrote a song kind of like that, didn't
they? They wrote one very, very similar to that, Chuck. Very similar.
Well, you know, every payday I thought about it. Because after allotment, every 2 weeks I got $14.
Yeah, yeah. And she got what?
She got 50.
Listen, you can live well 50 bucks if you know what you're doing.
Well, she did. She bought a dang car and everything, you know. Good talk to you, love.
All right, buddy, you take care of yourself. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255. Yeah, to get reminded with a $14 paycheck. Yeah, that'll remind you. Ludlow and Denny, Blue Willow Inn Gang, gracious hospitality, superb southern food, right there in beautiful Social Circle, Georgia. We'll have more conversation right after this.
Only 16 days before Groundhog Day.
I've talked to you before about the Jasper Jeep logo that you see on the rear window of cars everywhere. Well, that logo tells you a lot more than the name of the dealership where the car was purchased. Yes, sir, it says that this car was bought at a fair price. It says there was no hassle involved, no haggling, not even any negotiations. A fair price with no tricks ever. That's what that logo stands for. Let me put it this way. If your car has our logo on the back window, that is your guarantee of customer satisfaction. Listen again. That is your guarantee of customer satisfaction. Yes, sir. The Jasper Jeep logo can bring you a lot of peace of mind. Jasper Jeep, Dodge Chrysler Plymouth in Jasper, Georgia. Now they open 8 to 7, Monday through Saturday, but never, ever on Sunday. You tell them Ludlow Ford sent you by, and you are there to pick up your dream car at Jasper Jeep Dodge Chrysler Plymouth.
This is Profile America for Wednesday, January 17th. For golfers in many parts of the nation, January is a month spent dreaming of straight shots, fast greens, and above all, better weather. On this day in 1916, a group of golfers did more than dream about their favorite game. Some 30 of them, led by the legendary Walter Hagen, formed the Professional Golfers Association of America and developed the idea of a national championship. Today, some 27 million people play golf on the nation's nearly 15,000 courses, tallying up more than a million rounds of golf each day. Other millions enjoy tournaments from all over the world on television. Profile America is brought to you as a public service by the U.S. Census Bureau.
Planning your next vacation to New York City? Come see the Big Apple in all its glory. The bright lights of Broadway, Madison Square Garden, the legendary Central Park, the majestic Statue of Liberty, the World Trade Center, the Empire State Building, Rockefeller Center, Harlem, King Kong, Greenwich Village. New York is all that and more. And to help you in your exciting trip to the city that never sleeps, get your free, handy New York Tourism Board pamphlets chock full of helpful hints to make your New York travel smooth and easy. These informative pamphlets come in five categories entitled, So You've Been Mugged, So You've Been Stabbed, How to Better Your Chances in a Gang Attack, So You've Been Doused with Gasoline and Set Afire, and Why Avoiding Eye Contact with Mafia Members is Important. Don't be a victim. Get your free New York Tourism Board helpful travel pamphlets by sending a self-addressed stamped envelope to New York Tourism Board, Pier 13, New York, New York.
This has been a public service announcement brought to you by the New York Tourism Board and the Ad Council.
You shame me for fighting a proud one and small. But I hope I love you, and I hope you will change. So I quit my tears and didn't complain. Come to me with a simple goodbye. You tell me you're leaving, but you don't tell me why. Now we're here at the station, and you're getting on. And all I can think of is, thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. I didn't know how much longer I could go on. Watching you take the respect out of me. Watching you make a total wreck out of me. That big diesel motor's playing my song. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. That load on my mind got lighter when you got on. That shiny old bus is a beautiful sight. Put the black smoke rolling up around the taillight. It may sound kind of cruel, but I've been silent too long. Thank God and Greyhound.
That old boy had a little celebration right there. In the bus station, track 8, 1-800-572-8255. That's got to be the kind of the last word in a hate song. So here's what we're going to do. We've been talking hate songs here for a couple hours. We're going to shift gears at the top of the hour, coming along in a minute or two, and let you talk about whatever may be on your mind. We'll have some fun. We're going to not be able to do that tomorrow because Dr. Cooper will be here, and it'd be kind of rude to have a a guest of his importance, and wind up talking about pumpkin pie some. So we'll do that today. Anything you want to talk about within the next hour or so, pick up the phone and give us a call, 1-800-572-8255. We can continue with hate songs if you have one you've just been waiting to get in here and get rid of. Or we'll let you talk about anything that may be on your mind. Then do we have any apparent hate songs that we missed? I think we got them all. Everyone. No more hate songs, as a matter of fact. We even got the monkey on the back that looks like her. Mr. Completely owes us $10 for that. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. All you have to do is pick out a song and pick out anything. Pick out a topic and give us a call, and we will talk about it and have a good time with it. So jump in here and join us, 1-800-572-8255. Weather, just the big unknown. We'll talk about it if you want to. Let's go to Forsyth, Georgia, and talk to Joe. Hello, Joe.
Hello, Ludlow. How you doing?
I'm doing good, old friend. How you doing?
Okay, there's an old Rod Stewart song named Maggie May.
Maggie May.
And there's a line in there that says, Maggie, I wish I'd never seen your face.
Who hates her, doesn't he?
That is a hate song.
Yeah.
It's about an old college boy hooks up with an older gal and ends up dropping out of college, and it just didn't work out for him.
Bless his heart. I wonder how many times that story's been repeated over the years, Joe. That one or one just like it.
I heard that.
You take care, big boy.
Okay, thanks, brother. So
talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Our number, 1-800-572-8255. Bad-looking day out there. Going to be better tomorrow, but probably worse on Saturday. What we like to do, especially when we got snow in the area, like it's going to be for this weekend, this Saturday, is kind of get our heads together and track these things. You can do that, too, with what's on the network, because you know where it comes. It comes from Mississippi. 1-800-572-8255. Open line for our final hour together. Join us.
I owe my soul to the company store. Well, I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting in trouble, I'm my middle name. I was raised in the king, break my hand on my line. Can't go high-tone woman like me. Fuck the line, you load 16 tons. And what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Well, if you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other steel. If the right one won't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, and what do you get? Another day over and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. Company store.
This is the Ludlow Port Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, brought to you in part by AirTran Airways, It's Something Else, and by the Lanier Lodge. The toll-free lines are now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. Or in Greater Atlanta, 770-205-2741. And now, here's Ludlow Port.
Well, good morning, Fun Seekers, and welcome back to this drippy, rainy day for us today. It's going to be all right by and by, but for the moment it's drippy and it is rainy, and we're going to talk about just about anything on your mind. We'd like to have you join us. 1-800-572-8255 as we go to Cleveland, Tennessee, and talk to DJ. Hello, DJ.
Hey, Ludlow. Really enjoy your show.
Thank you, buddy.
First time caller.
Oh, we're glad you're here.
And I've been off and on this morning, but I hadn't heard anybody mention Reba McEntire's Rainy Night in Georgia as a hate song.
You think that's a hate song, Rainy Night in Georgia? It could be.
And my favorite's Johnny Cash is Boy Named Sue.
Boy Named Sue. I guess I think Johnny Cash's best hate song, in my opinion, was Frankie and Johnny.
Yeah, that's a good one, too.
Yeah, that is a good one.
Mm-hmm. But just wanted to...
Okay, bud.
In. You have a good day.
You do the same. I'll talk to you soon.
Okay, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255, beautiful Gainesville, Georgia. And Charles is on the line. Hello,
hey,
Charles.
You remember, we grew up with this lady, Kitty Wells.
Yeah.
And she can really sing those old tear-jerking hate songs, too.
Great talent.
There's a song that she sings that, when she gets through, she just tires us men up. For every good girl that goes wrong, there's a man to blame. You remember that song?
Oh.
Oh, boy.
Nor do I agree with the sentiment. I think, in most cases, it's the women leading the men astray, don't you think so?
That's right.
Denny says, absolutely.
Now, when she gets through, you can say she has put us down.
Laid well, one on us.
What I'm leading up to about a couple weeks ago, they honored her on WSM one night through the week.
Yeah.
She's 81 years old. She sung about 30 minutes, and she sounded just like she did 40, 50 years ago.
Isn't that great?
And you know, she's married. Do you remember John and Jack?
Yeah.
But she's married to Jack. And he was on the program also, and he's something like 87 years old.
Wow.
And he's still sounding good.
Good for them.
But I just thought I'd call you. And yeah, no Kitty, she's supposed to be retiring. That was her retirement party. And she belted out some songs that make tears come to your eyes.
She's never going to retire.
No.
She's too good at what she does.
Well, good to speak to you.
My pleasure, buddy. You take care of yourself. Talk to you soon.
All right.
1-800-572-8255. Yeah, I heard Perry Como do a Christmas show, not this past year, but the year before. And, you know, Perry Como's in his 80s, and he doesn't have what he used to have voice-wise, but the guy's still a showman, and I thoroughly enjoyed him, and I hope he lives to be 500 and does a Christmas show every year. Our number, 1-800-572-8255, if you want to become a cyber wacko or you want to tell your relatives in Bayonne, New Jersey, how they can pick up this show. It's www.funseekers.net. That's the Bayonne number. www.funseekers.net, and we'll be right there in your living room. Benny's asking me a question. Are the people in Bayonne, going to understand what I'm saying? I doubt that. They'll get to you. What? Okay, Bayonne. Bayonets, that's very good. Very good. Yeah, that's probably true. Let's get right back to the phones and talk to, we're going to take care of some business, and then we're going to talk to our special sweetheart, the Happy Cooker. We'll do that right after I tell you about my buddies at Airtran Airways. Listen, you're going to like these folks, going to save you some money, going to take you bye-bye in the airplane. It's Atlanta's second largest airline, and it just keeps on growing. You know, last year, Airtran added several cities to its growing list of destinations across the South and East. With the addition of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania in December, you can now save big money on 33 destinations from Atlanta. Of course, since we've been talking about Airtran, you know the fare to Pittsburgh is going to be great. So right now, you can fly nonstop from Atlanta to Pittsburgh for only $69 one way. And at Airtran, has fewer restrictions in the airline around, so you never have to stay over a Saturday night or even buy a round-trip ticket. For reservations to Pittsburgh or any other 32 locations where Airtran flies, book online at airtran.com or call your travel agent or Airtran Airways at 770-994-8258. Airtran Airways, your airline, has arrived.
here for the Environmental Defense Fund at the supermarket with some smart shoppers. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what's for dinner?
Pudding!
Excellent. What kind?
Vanilla.
Chocolate.
Lemon mousse.
Oh, how sophisticated.
Why, thank you.
Okay, shoppers, when shopping for pudding, what's the most important thing to look for on the label?
100% pudding!
Besides that,
packaging from recyclable materials.
Bingo. All sorts of products and packaging are now being made from the paper, plastic, metal, and glass that you recycle. But to keep recycling working, you have to buy those products. So when you pick up a package, read the label.
Just make sure it's pudding.
It's for all kinds of products.
As long as they're pudding.
This is Cindy Sang for a free brochure on buying recycled. Call 1-800-CALL-EDF.
Or 1-800-PUDDING.
Come on.
Oh, all right.
1-800-CALL-EDF. This message from the Ad Council, the U.S. EPA, and the Environmental Defense Fund.
1-800-572-8255. My buddy, the Happy Cooker. On board. Hello, beautiful lady.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm fine, but weak in the knees. I'm still getting over that bayonets business.
Yeah.
That man is sick and twisted. I think you need to replace him. Bayonets? That is so funny.
I think he was the one that thought about people from Charlotte being called charlatans, too.
And if you're from County Cork, you're a Corky.
A Corker, yeah.
A Corker, yes, exactly. What about if you're from Limerick? Are you a Limerickian? Or,
I don't know.
This could be a whole show.
We'll have to work on it. It could be, yeah.
It could be really strange.
Yeah.
And you know we'd all listen, because we are.
Oh, yes.
I want to enlist the Wacko's help.
All right.
I'm trying to put together an installation of officers for a club,
uh-huh.
And I've been to 88,000 of them that were so boring, and I want to do something strange and weird, and who better to put on the job but the Wackos?
You're starting a club?
It is an established club.
Okay.
But I'm doing an annual installation of officers.
Okay.
And you stand them up and you say something.
Yeah.
And I don't want to read this stuff out of the book, and I don't want to hold up a daffodil and say, daffodils are for resilience and, you know, all this stuff that's been done 1,000 times.
Uh-huh.
So I'm trying to put together a little paragraph on each person and using song titles to put the paragraph together. Now, I can come up with lots of song titles that are appropriate for somebody who is on the horticulture committee. Don't make a crack about that. And et cetera, et cetera. But what I need is names of three ladies, and I'm trying to find a song that either mentions these three names or preferably has it in the title.
The reason you're having such a hard time is because you don't have a hush.
I had to 1956.
I had three names and I've forgotten them.
No.
So you're doing it again. Now, let me ask you a question. I want to find out what you're doing because I want you to know what you're doing. You got three ladies, right, who have been elected.
You see, they have names. I want to use their names.
Of course you do. If you just hush on it, I'll form a question.
Yes, dear.
You're gonna swear three ladies in. Do you already know their names?
Yes, I do.
So what we're looking for now is a song that mentions their names.
That's right.
What are those names?
So glad you asked.
That sounds Russian. I don't really know. Go ahead.
Ruth.
Yeah.
Midge. Yeah, I know. That's a good one. And Millie. Yeah. And Millie Vanilli is out.
Yeah, I'm sure.
And I have considered... Oh, Ruth E., don't take your love to town. But that is a stretch.
Yeah, it is.
So if the Wackos can help me, I would certainly appreciate them.
When's our deadline?
Oh, gosh, we've got lots of time. I think it's the 10th of February. But you know how they are. They'll forget me, so. Yeah.
Well, what we'll do, we're not going to let them forget you. First thing Friday morning, which is our catch-up day, I want you to call and nag them.
Well, I can do that.
And remind me to remind them that we're looking for songs with Ruth, Midge, and Millie.
I can do that.
Suppose we just wrote a new song for any of them. Would that be all right?
That'd be wonderful.
Okay.
It would suit me fine. I'm poor but not proud.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take what I can get.
Have you thought about getting out of this club?
I've considered it strongly. Yes, I have. I have thought now maybe I should join some motorcycle club because there's lots of songs to go with the names of guys who are in motorcycle clubs.
Exactly right.
From Wheels on up.
Yeah, yeah. Ruth, Midge, and Millie.
Yes, sir.
We're working on it even as we speak.
You're a dear man.
Friday morning.
Yes, sir.
And we'll start over again.
Okay.
All right.
All right, bye-bye.
See you then. Go cook something.
Yeah, well, I'm planning to.
Talk to you, my
bye-bye.
Dear.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Fun, fun lady. A little nuts, but fun. But that's the reason she's having a hard time. She calls people to ask about that and never takes a breath. She's got little things right under her ears like gills. We have some callers like that, and they just, and when they do that, they're ready to go. They got 3 hours worth of air right there behind those gills. You watch it, if they're wearing a little hard around their neck, a little diamond hard, well, you can see it's bouncing. It's vibration for those gills. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. Listen, I want to tell you about the Blue Willow Inn again. You're going to love this place. Let me tell you why. Great place to eat. Beautiful Greek Revival mansion that they have gone in there and made absolutely brand new. I mean, absolutely brand new. Never going to beat this place. Food, well, Southern food is their specialty. When you walk up there to look at some of that stuff, you're going to absolutely be amazed. I mean, you can look at that chicken and know that it's good chicken. It's that brown, golden fried chicken. Ham, delicious. All the beans, pole beans, green beans, pinto beans. And listen, something special. A Fun Seeker special, 25% off the regular price, good now through April. To receive this discount, reservations must be made in advance, and the discount must be requested. The customers to tell the time of making reservations that they want the Fun Seeker special discount. Then when they dine, receive a 25% discount. Up through April 14th, good food, good people, good place to eat, and you're going to save some money. You tell them Ludlow told you to call.
It's good to see you, baby. It's been a long, long while. We're both a whole lot older and seen a lot of miles. But things are really different now since the good old days. And you've been in some trouble since we went our separate ways. We'll have to say hello maybe some other time instead. Told you only by the police and my wife thinks you're dead.
He is some more trying to get rid of her. We'll have to talk some more some other time and place. My wife thinks you did. 1-800-572-8255. Spartanburg, South Carolina, and my friend Red on the radio. What do you say, Red?
Morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, Tiger?
Oh, doing fine.
Good.
Ludlow.
Good.
Just wanted to comment on what the guy called in about a while ago, a few minutes ago.
What was that?
Talking about Kitty Wells.
Yeah.
He said that was on WSM, so I assume it wasn't on television. If he had been watching television, she'd have probably been blue if she had Jack up there with her. She'd have been scared to death.
Really?
It was Johnny and Jack, you know, Johnny Wright and Jack Anglin.
Yeah.
Johnny got killed on the way to Patsy Cline's funeral.
It probably wasn't him, was it?
No, it was Johnny Wright she's married to.
Okay. Okay.
And I believe the song he was referring to was God Didn't Make Honky Tonk Angels.
It wasn't God who made Honky Tonk.
Yeah,
okay.
It wasn't God who made Honky Tonk Angels.
Right. That was a big hit for her.
Mm-hmm. And behind every woman that's gone bad, a man's to blame or something.
Yeah.
I believe that was it.
That's what we call folk.
Mm-hmm.
Folk stuff.
Yeah.
Not true, but makes a good story.
Lord, I used to sing those songs. For 37 years, I sang those songs.
Did you really? Professionally?
Yeah. I never did get popular. I never did record record. But
you were singing your guts out for 37 years.
Yeah, I was on the road from New Orleans to Canada like a window shade going up and down.
Boy, that must be a tough way to live.
It was.
Tough way to live.
I got tired of it. In 1987, I said, this is it.
Yeah.
And I quit.
You know, I can be out there for a week or 10 days, and I'm ready to come home. I can only imagine somebody for 30 years.
37 years of it.
Yeah, well, but you're doing something you love, and how many folks can say they did that for 37 years?
Yeah, not too many.
Yeah.
But I tell you, that that ride and got the best of up and down the road. I remember one night we went into New Orleans. It was the first time I was there. We rode up Bourbon Street about 3 o'clock in the morning.
Uh-huh.
And those girls in there dancing on the bars and the trumpets blowing. I thought for a few minutes that Gabriel was coming.
Now, Gabriel, you didn't go find Gabriel in the French Quarter.
No.
There's some parts down there that Satan won't even go in. Red?
Believe me, buddy.
It's a pleasure, old Fred. You take care of yourself.
Yeah, I got an old doctor here that I go to.
Uh-huh.
Dr. Blissdell, he's from, excuse me, he's from down in New Orleans. He's one of those colon doctors. And he is a character, I'm telling you. And he walked in, first time I saw him, he walked in, he said, "I'm George Blissdell." He didn't say I'm Dr. Blissdell, so from then on, I've just been calling him my old Cajun buddy.
Well, there you go. There you go. Well, you take care, Red. I'll talk to you, buddy.
I'll see you later, buddy.
Call us soon.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. You think Red may have, could have just one or two road stories? I wonder if he just had just two or three that involved alcohol. Hope you call back. Res is for it. 1-800-572-8255. Spartanburg, South Carolina. My friend Joe.
Ludlow.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing all right.
Good.
Listen, on that song, George Jones, "He Stopped Loving Her Today."
Yeah.
Curly Putman wrote that.
Okay.
Carried around with him in his pocket before it was finished. Trying to get George a recording. George said, "Well, the girl's got to come back." You know.
Mm-hmm.
Before he would record it. And
you mean the girl in the song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the talking part in that song, it took him 3 days to record it.
Really?
Because he was drinking so bad.
Really? Yeah, you came mix a whole lot of whiskey and a whole lot of talking.
And Curly Putman also wrote "The Green, Green Grass of Home."
Oh, did he?
That's a sad song.
Well, it is a sad song, but that's a song going to pay him big residuals for the rest of his life.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good. Is George still drinking like you?
Well, you know, they had that wreck and they found that half a bottle of vodka.
Yeah.
So I'm sure he's drinking to a certain extent.
Yeah. I wonder if you got it that bad, if you can drink a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
I think he probably drank. He dies, you know.
Yeah.
They're that kind of people.
Yep. All right. It's a tough fight. I know some very good people who fought that all their lives and never scored a point.
Right.
You take care of yourself, big boy.
That info helps you a little bit.
It does, and I appreciate it. You come see us.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah, that's a fight with the alcohol. Tough, tough fight. Because I know some good men that let that stuff get a hold of them and was never quite able to get back on that horse after they got thrown off. Tough, tough, tough battle. Our number 1-800-572-8255. Ludlow and Denny, the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Like to hear from you. Easy for you to get in here from no matter where you're listening. If you can hear us, it's a toll-free call. So pick up the phone, call 1-800-572-8255.
Stuff and disappeared. Nobody knew what happened. Drugs have been following you. Not trouble what you're looking like. There's trouble going in. And I can see the kind of trouble you could get me in. You better pay attention to every word I said. Cause you want it by the police. And my wife thinks you're dead.
The Fun Seekers Network spectacular pre-Groundhog Day celebration. Next Monday, January 22nd, featuring dignitaries from around the world and guest speaker Alvin the Chipmunk. Join us for the pre-Groundhog Day special next Monday right here on the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
Bye to you, baby. I'm glad we got to talk. But I'm faithful to my wife, and I don't never break the law. I don't know where you're headed for, but I know where you've been. We reminisce, now let's just go our separate ways again. Go find another ex-sweetheart to hang around instead. Call you on it by the police, and my wife thinks you're dead. I said you wanted by the police, and my wife thinks you're dead.
Boy, we're having fun now. 1-800-572-8255, Griffin, Georgia. And Wade is on the air. Hello, Wade.
Hey, how you doing? Talked to you in a long time, Ludlow.
Good to have you back, buddy.
I tell you, there are two or three songs I thought of. One of them was called Cold as Ice. I think it's called You're Cold as Ice. It was a rock group that did that.
I don't really know that one.
Another one is Willie Nelson and the guy that sang on the theme song for the Dukes of Hazzard did one about...
Waylon?
Yeah, like Waylon Jennings, and they did one about... How many must it take to satisfy you?
Yeah, okay.
And then the other one that I don't know if anybody's called in is Opal, You Had to Ask Me.
Opal, You Asked Me, yeah. We got that. We're probably the only radio company in the world that's got that record.
Yeah, now, if people, you're talking about music today, people that like bluegrass music should go see Old Brother, Where Art Thou? It's got George Clooney in it.
Oh, the movie.
Yeah, it is bluegrass music from one end to the other.
I've heard good things about it. Pretty funny, too, isn't it?
It's pretty funny. It's funny in places. The music, to me, is better than the comedy.
Okay.
But it's good to talk to you again, Ludlow.
Okay, buddy. Don't be gone so long.
Thank you again.
Take care. Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. Morristown, Tennessee, and Bill on the line. Hello, Bill.
Hey, how you doing, Ludlow?
Doing good, buddy. How you doing?
I'm doing wonderful. Great show as usual.
Thank you.
Talking about George Jones a few minutes ago, heard the man call in talking about his drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Went to a concert in Pigeon Forge, I guess it's back around the first week of November when George was over there. We went in and sat down, and of course, you know, George has been known not to show up sometimes.
Yeah, no show, yeah.
But we sat down.
I heard about that.
Yeah. He's got quite a reputation for that. But anyway, we sat down, and his band came out, started playing, and they played, and they continued to play, and we were beginning to think, uh-oh, something's wrong again.
Yeah.
But George did come out in about 20 minutes, and he was really in good form. He was he looked like he's perfectly sober to me. He made a comment, sort of a little joke. He said, I'm going to have to take a break every few songs. And he says, I've got some spring water I'm drinking. And he said, and he laughed, he said, it really is spring water. And he sang for about an hour, and it was a fantastic show, and he really did look like he was in really good health now. He made the comment that he saw a side of life now that he hasn't seen in a long time, and he liked it.
Well, that's good, because this man has been blessed with a great talent.
Yeah, exactly.
And to have him waste any of it because of some Jack Daniels is just a crying shame. And I just hope it, and, you know, I understand what kind of fight that is. I understand it.
Yeah.
But a guy with that much to live for needs to get involved in that fight and stay there.
Well, you know, he gave a lot of credit to his new wife. I think she's really changed his life a lot. And he gives her most of the credit for turning his life around. And I think I was privy to see him. I was in Las Vegas last year about this time, and I went into one of the casinos and was sitting there somewhere looking over the shoulder of my friend who was at a blackjack table. And I looked over to my left, and I saw this fellow sitting over there, and I told my friend, I said, that looks like George Jones. And sure enough, it was. And I walked around to, you know, I didn't want to bother him because, you know, celebrities don't particularly like that sort of thing. I didn't want to bother him, but I did walk around and sort of stand near the table there and just sort of observe him for a few minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Wanted to get his autograph. I thought, and now I wish I had, if I could kick myself for not doing it. But anyway, to make a long story short, he looked like he's in really good health this concert.
Well, that's good. I'm pulling for him. I'd like to see that old boy just sing about another 25 years.
Well, the voice like he's got, you know, we all hope he does.
Yeah.
So, anyway, Ludlow, enjoy your show.
Well, man, you take care of yourself and come by here when you can.
Let me ask you one question.
Sure.
Going to Hilton Head Island about 3 weeks ago, about this time.
Mm-hmm.
We were going down through, we had just left Spartanburg, headed down I-26, trying to pick your show up, and I kept thumbing the dial, and I finally picked you up with about 5 minutes left in the show. What stations or affiliates are there in around South Carolina, Danny, that carry your show?
Oh, I think once you cross that line over there, let me just see here. I'm looking. You got everything from... here in Atlanta, you got, let's see, Cartersville, Canelia. You're looking for something in South Carolina?
Yeah, I was going down 26 toward Columbia.
Yeah, okay.
And I finally picked you up on some station, but I really don't know which one I was on.
Well,
it may have been a Spartanburg station.
It could have been Anderson, Greenville.
Decor,
Royston, Barnwell, any of those.
Oh, okay. So it could be one of
them. Clinton, Greenville, Fountain Inn. Any of those.
Well, I was looking for you, and I found you, but with 5 minutes to go. But anyway, I just wondered.
Someday, we're going to be on every radio station in the world.
Hey, sounds like a good thing.
And you just pick up that telephone and turn us on, and we'll be right there with you.
Hey, sounds good.
Well, man, you take care. Have a great day, pal.
You too.
Bye-bye now. 1-800-572-8255, Ludlow and Denny, Fun Seekers Radio Network. Now, they're hinting around, and matter of fact, doing something a little strong hinting. They're talking about snow on Saturday, so we're going to follow that for you, and you follow it for us, Denny. You see any signs of that at your house, wish you would like to be the first to know, and we promise we'll do the same thing for you. Keep it on the Weather Channel. That's the way you do it. Our number, 1-800-572-8255, 1-800-572-TALK, Ludlow and Denny, all over the Fun Seekers Radio Network.
Hi, this is a guy with his hand up, and when I'm on this planet, I always listen to the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Network.
I've talked to you before about the Jasper Jeep logo that you see on the rear window of cars everywhere. Well, that logo tells you a lot more than the name of the dealership where the car was purchased. Yes, sir, it says that this car was bought at a fair price. It says there was no hassle involved, no haggling, not even any negotiations. A fair price with no tricks ever. That's what that logo stands for. Let me put it this way. If your car has our logo on the back window, that is your guarantee of customer satisfaction. Listen again. That is your guarantee of customer satisfaction. Yes, sir. The Jasper Jeep logo can bring you a lot of peace of mind. Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth in Jasper, Georgia. Now, they open 8 to 7, Monday through Saturday, but never, ever on Sunday. You tell them Ludlow Ford sent you by, and you are there to pick up your dream car at Jasper Jeep Dodge Chrysler Plymouth.
I begged her not to go, said I could not live without her. She said, don't be dramatic, you'll survive. She drove away, the sky turned gray, I cried all night about her. I'm still breathing, but her leaving hurts more each day I'm alive. If I can't live without her, how come I ain't dead?
I think that's a valid question. If I can't live without her, how come I ain't dead? 1-800-572-8255. Noonan, Georgia, my buddy, the plowboy. Hello, big guy. How you doing?
Good morning, Ludlow.
Morning to you.
Doing a little bit better every day.
Good. You had one of those knock down, kill you, and stomp on your colds.
Well, the old kind of cold, it gets to your chest, kind of, and gives you a cough and a congestion, just kind of clogs your throat.
Awful, just awful.
Those terrible kinds. Well, I tell you, on a day like this, the snails are moving faster than I am. Definitely, when you're used to being on the outside, it does slow you down a little.
Yeah, it does.
But I still enjoy it, though.
Yeah.
I'll just put my rain gear on and go out and do what I have to do, pick up my newspaper and read it from cover to cover.
Well, you need to also plan on trying to stay dry as much as you can. With the cold you had, you don't want to bring that bad boy back.
That's the truth. And I maybe go into town, pick up a few items, and just kind of take it easy.
Yeah, that's good.
But I don't let any kind of weather dull my day. I just adapt to it and enjoy it. And rainy or sunshine or whatever, I just appreciate every day.
You know, a man that makes his living outside like you do, pretty much got to accept what comes, and you can't break your schedule up.
Yeah.
Because those you can't tell those cows that they're not going to be fed today because it's rainy.
Right.
They ain't going to listen to
that. Yeah. Well, enjoying the show today, and a lot of sad songs been calling in. I don't know that I know any more sad songs than have already been said.
And we're not sad. These are hate songs.
Yeah, hate songs.
Hate songs. Yeah,
there's some mean songs there. Sister Packy Mama, she was a mean one.
You remember that? Yeah.
Yes, sir, V.
Yeah, that's got to be at the top of anybody's list.
Uh-huh.
All right, big boy, you take care of yourself. Let us hear from you.
All right.
Thank you now.
Thank you now.
Bye-bye.
Bye. 1-800-572-8255.
We'd like to hear from you. Jump in here and join us. I want to tell you, AirTran Airways gang, you take my word for it when I tell you it is something else. 1-800-572-8255. Boy, we're having fun now. You just heard the Flyboy. Flyboy went with us on our trip to Scandinavia. Just had a big time. Speaking of trips, I call it Segway. That's a town in Alaska. Isn't that Segway, Alaska? We are leaving on May 26th for Ireland. No matter what happens, that's when we're going on May 26th. We want you to be with us. Now, let me tell you what else. If you have already sent and have your brochure and have already made a decision on this thing but haven't let us know, need to do that now because we're going to have to wind up the advertising and everything else on this thing next month. So go ahead and call us if you've made a decision on this thing, and we'll tell you where to go from there. And also, if you need a passport or whatever, we'll tell you the way to get that with less problem and less trouble. It's going to be great. 12 nights in beautiful hotels, full Irish breakfast every day, and dinner every day. 24 meals, as a matter of fact. We're going to go to some Irish cabaret shows, visit some of the most famous pubs in Ireland, and we want you with us. We're going to tour the Waterford Crystal Factory. We're going to visit Barney Castle and kiss the famous Barney Stone, if you want to. We're going to tour the famous rig of Kerry and spend the night in world-famous Killarney, made famous by homesick Irish guys. We're going to stand on 700-foot-high cliff to Moher. We're going to do it all, gang. Here's how you get the information. Do this today, 1-888-256-3044. 1-888-256-3044. That's a toll-free call, and we want you with us. Give us that call today. 1-800-572-8255, Brunswick. What it is, who needs me down there, that sort of thing. But we'll come back. We love him.
How about old Frankie and Johnny? Anybody put that in there?
Yeah, that's one of my favorites, one of my personal favorites. I think that with I think Johnny Cash's version of Frankie and Johnny is just about the best one.
Yeah, there have been several of them done it. I enjoyed most of them, but I didn't know if them I hadn't heard it. I've been in and out and in and out of the vehicle.
Yeah.
I didn't know if anybody had come up with that one.
What kind of weather y'all got on there today?
It's cloudy. It's about chilly, but from sounds of a lot better than what you got up there.
Yeah, it's just an absolute mess up here.
No, it's all right. It hadn't rained or nothing yet.
All right, well.
They've been threatening. How about the one old George Jones had? I give her the bird. You ever heard that one?
I give her the bird.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, it was about I had heard it a few times, and then I hadn't heard it. Well, he had got married, and his in-laws had given him a pirate or something, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
now I remember.
And the bird told on him, you know?
Yeah, that's exactly right. I had forgotten that.
And then when they got divorced and everything, he gave her the bird, you know?
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah, give it back to her.
That is funny.
But,
I love it.
I thought that was a pretty good one, but it wasn't exactly a love song.
maybe more of a hate song, you know.
Yeah, kind of a hate song. Hey, we look forward to seeing you when you get down this way.
Okay, buddy, we'll schedule something as soon as we can, and I promise you we won't keep it a secret.
Hey, I hear you. All right, have a good one.
Okay, old friend, take care of yourself. Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. We'd like to have you jump in here and join us. Now, something else we'd like for you to do, Lanier Lodge. Remember that name, Lanier Lodge, exit 15, Georgia 400. We'd like for you to do what we did. We made it our headquarters for now. We want you to make it your headquarters for your mountain or Lake Lanier trips. Now, let me tell you why. It's convenient to Lake Lanier. Very, very close, a couple miles, maybe a mile from Lake Lanier. Good food here, good people, out of the traffic. Also convenient to most of the little towns in the mountains where these festivals are going on. You know, they have something in Dahlonega on a regular basis, and they have all these festivals, from the Moonshine Festival to the Gold Rush and all that. You need to be up there. A lot of good things to do, good things to see, to enjoy the beautiful mountains. Now, also convenient to North Georgia Premium Outlet Mall, which is right up the road, 8 or 9 miles. easy for you to find just to get on 400 and go north. But after a day of shopping, because they got 100, 120, 140 stores there, out with malls, it's easy for you to come back on down there and get you a good hot shower, watch a little television, have a good hot meal, and then get some more rest and be ready to go back and shop another day. Lanier Lodge, exit 15, Georgia 400 in Cumming, Georgia. Call them, mention my name when you make your reservation. They'll give you a special discount and you'll save a few bucks. 770-889-3045. 770-889-3045. Tell them Ludlow told you to call. Boy, we are having fun now. We are just giggling to our little side, just absolutely 1-800-572-8255. Let's talk to Tennessee Ted on the radio. Hello, Tennessee Ted.
Hello, Ludlow.
How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Nice to hear you.
Well, nice to be heard.
Ah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been a lot of hate in my life.
Has it really?
Yeah.
Tell me about it, Ted.
Oh, boy. I tell you.
Tell me.
Dating was something else.
Tough, yeah.
Yeah, it ended up a lot of hate,
yeah.
But I enjoyed it. You know, everything from the late night dinners to the early morning breakfast to hiding in the bushes, the restraining orders, all that stuff. Really enjoyed that.
Your love knew no bounds.
Yeah.
Till the police got there.
One of my favorite hate songs is "I've Been Down in the Mouth Since You Knocked Out My Front Teeth."
Mm-hmm.
I like that one.
That is sad.
Yeah. And my personal favorite is "Thank God and Penicillin You're Gone."
That's your favorite, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of my favorites.
Mm-hmm. That's "The Love That Lingers" is what you're talking about.
The love that stays behind.
Yeah.
And "I Can't Chase You as Much as I Should Since I Lost My Shoe in Your Back Pocket."
Yeah, that's unusual.
Yeah. Well, Luddy,
yeah, man.
I've got to go.
Okay.
Flying up to Alaska to pick some vegetables.
Are you really?
Yeah. Picks a few pianos.
Yeah.
Maybe a ukulele or two.
Okay. You take care of yourself.
Igloo to you, too.
Yeah. I'll talk to you later.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. A different type caller. Tennessee Ted. That's only the second time Ted's called. Ted's good caller. Our number 1-800-572-8255. Ludlow and Denny. And I want you to remember that we have a quest here for the Happy Cooker. And this won't officially start till Friday. But you can start mentally working on this today. It would help her out. She needs three songs with three women's names in them. If they exist. If they don't exist, then we're going to have to write some. Ruth, Midge, and Millie. Got those? Be working on them. We'll call you or talk to you on Friday and get those back. Your version of it anyway. Trying Georgia and my friend Bobby. Hello, Bobby.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good.
I've been out a little bit fast this morning. I wonder if anybody had mentioned Earl Had to Die.
Yeah, we do. That's about the Dixie Chicks.
Yes.
Yeah, why did they kill Earl?
Because he was mean to her.
Okay. Well, that's a good enough reason.
Sure is.
Yeah, no question about that. But they did mention that. I've never heard that. I guess if I keep listening to the radio, I will hear it. But I hadn't heard it yet, but I'm anxious to. Earl Had to Die. That's kind of touching.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Got a video on. Need to see the video, too.
How did they kill him, Mommy?
I'm not sure how they killed him.
Didn't tell?
Mm-mm. Anyway, I just wanted to add that in.
Okay, my sweet. You take care of yourself.
Okay, all right.
Talk to you later.
All right, bye-bye.
Yeah, we do need to know how he died, didn't he? And if the song doesn't explain how he died, we'll make up a way. What do you do to a man who abuses an entire female vocal group? Not just one chick, the Dixie Chicks. They took turns at shooting him. In any event, we're going to have to get on out of here and make room for your more than wonderful local radio station. But just when we're looking for three songs, one about Ruth, one about Midge, and one about Millie, and we need those no later than Friday, because we promised We promise a happy cooker. We'll have those for him. So also, don't forget, put this on your calendar. Dr. Cooper will be in here in the morning, bright and early, starting with our first hour and going right through the morning. We're just telling you how to keep from having a large waist. He's going to tell you how, what kind of vitamins to take, what kind of anything to take, what kind of exercise to take. So you'll be here tomorrow, because for a lot of us, he's going to help us with our New Year's resolutions, and that is important. He's a good guy, and he'll be here having a big time. Then Friday, of course, what we do every Friday, catch-up day, we just get busy and have a good time. So, and we got the next couple of days outlined for you. You be sure and be on board. See you in the morning. Between now and then, you do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
My song, thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. That load on my mind got lighter when you got on. That shiny old bus, it's a beautiful sight. Put the black smoke rolling up around the taillight. It may sound kind of cruel, but I've been silent too long. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone. Thank God and Greyhound, you're gone.
Ludlow again, just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friends, and I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. Ludlow again, just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friends, and I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. Ludlow again, that band of black old dolls out on the airwaves. They're the best of friends, insisting that the only way is the fair way. And that's why I say, Ludlow again, just can't wait to hear Ludlow again. The life I love is here in Ludlow with my friends, and I can't wait to hear Ludlow again. No, I can't wait to hear Ludlow again.